This is another sample problem for average shear strain. So for this problem, we have a piece of rubber which is originally rectangular, and then we are asked to determine the average shear strain at A if the corners B and D are subjected to displacement as shown. So ito yung bagong shape natin, no? Yung dashed lines. And then that caused the rubber to distort as shown by the dashed lines. Okay, so ngayon, problem states na ito lang yung i-analyze natin, point A. Kahit na kung observe natin dito, may mga movement din dito sa side na BC and side na DC. But since specifically yung problem natin states na dito lang sa A, so i-analyze natin ngayon is yung movement lang at side AD and on the side AB. Okay? So ito lang bali yung mga co-compute natin, ha? Average shear strain. Okay? The change in angle AD and then the change in angle AB. Therefore, since at point A, dalawa yung nag-change na angles, masasabi natin na the average shear strain at point A along the XY plane is just equal to the sum dito sa ito, AD and AB. Okay? We have AB and AD. Okay? So, kasi dalawa yung nag-change na angle. Anyway, isasolve muna natin yung sa AB. For AB, you can have tangent. Ito yun, no? Opposite over adjacent. So, madali lang to, no? The opposite distance is 2 millimeters. And then you have the adjacent is 300 millimeters. So, tangent gamma AB is just equal to gamma AB. No? For smaller angles, tangent theta is just equal to theta. So, 2 millimeters divided by 300 millimeters. That's 6.67 times 10 to the negative 3 radians. So, ito bali yung value ng angle natin. Okay? And then for AD, this one, we have tangent pa rin. And then you have the opposite over adjacent. No? So, you have the 3 mm over 400 millimeters. 3 divided by 400. Kasi ito yung angle na i-consider natin. So, that's opposite divided by adjacent. So, that's 3 divided by 400 equals 7.5 times 10 to the negative 3 radians. And then, using this original equation natin, makukuha natin yung gamma xy at point A as the sum of 6.67 times 10 to the negative 3 and 7.5 times 10 to the negative 3, which is equal to 0.01417 radians. So, yan na yung average na shear strain, no? At point A considering the movement, no? Represented by dashed lines. Yun. Sana ay medyo mabilis, no? Pero anyway, madali lang naman talaga yung average shear strain, no? Katulad lang din ng average normal strain. So, yun. Sana ulit may natutunan kayo kahit na medyo mabilis tayo. And yun, see you ulit sa ating next na lesson, next na video, and thank you for watching.